How you doing? Llewyn Davis.
Oh, hello. I've heard your music. And heard many nice things about you from Jim and Gene and from others.
You have not heard one nice thing about me from Gene.
Oh, it's fairly well, my darling true. I'm leaving in the first hour of the morning.
No, you don't want to go anywhere. And that's why all the same shit is going to keep happening to you, because you want it to.
Is that why?
Yes, and also because you're an asshole.
Maybe the coast of California. So it's fairly well.
What'd you say you played?
Folk songs.
Folk songs. I thought you said you were a musician.
Another day, another time. It ain't believing.
Folk singer with a cat.
It's not my cat, I just didn't know what to do with it.
Really? So, did you bring your dick along too?
I should have had you wear double condoms. Well, we shouldn't have done it in the first place, but if you ever do it again, which is a favor to women everywhere, you should not. But if you do, you should be wearing condom on condom and then wrap it in electrical tape.
Though the weather is against me, and the wind blows hard, the rain, she's a turning in
day. I'm interested in gigging here.
Okay, let's hear something.
You don't want to hear the record?
Why should I? You're here. Play me something.
Play me something from Inside Llewyn Davis.
Okay.
So, at this point, the Coen brothers have really earned my loyalty and respect, so no matter how bizarre a trailer might seem, or a step back career-wise, I'll still see the movie. I'll still try it. And there were certainly interesting things in the trailer, little Coen-esque touches that get you excited, like John Goodman's lines, or the visuals, like the stairs in the beginning. And I think Carey Mulligan looks like she's doing a nice job. But, you know, I have to say, I just feel like this is like not even as like exciting or vibrant as early Coen brothers. And I don't know why. You know, when they can make such exciting movies like Fargo and Raising Arizona, and even, you know, the True Grit remake, which I thought was at least something new and exciting for them. I don't know why they would kind of make a movie that's like a step back. This reminds me a lot of Oh Brother, Where Art Thou, another musical-themed film. And to their credit, they like to give themselves a challenge of picking styles of music that are not particularly popular. So I know it's a joke in the movie, but at the same time, you know, you have to get audiences to be willing to sit through that. The other weird thing about this trailer is that it does not show, I think, the two biggest draws for the film. Obviously, the first one is Justin Timberlake. He's credited as being in the movie. If you have Justin Timberlake in your movie, I don't know why you wouldn't show it. I know that a lot of you are like, he's not a serious actor. It's ridiculous. But at the same time, you know, it's the whole thing I'm saying about selling movie tickets. And there is a huge group of people who like Justin Timberlake. And we get at the very least, we get the trailer more attention, even if maybe not a huge amount of movie tickets, but still, it would, you know, it would get more publicity for the film. The other person that I wish they had shown was Adam Driver from Girls. He plays Lena Dunham's boyfriend in the first season, and he's still in the second season. He had a small part in Lincoln as well. I really think he's a talented actor, and I think he has a really bright future ahead of him. And he's I think he'd be a perfect fit with the Coen brothers, and at least I think. I haven't seen anything because they're just sitting on it. Maybe he has a very small role. But so that's what I think about this film. I'll see it because it's a Coen Brothers movie. As I said, you know, they've earned my going to see their film. Will I see it in theaters? I'm not sure. It depends what else is playing. It depends on the buzz of the film. But at the same time, I mean, like, I don't know who's cutting their trailers, and I don't know who's advising them, because, you know, it's not like the Coen Brothers are a hit every time. You know, they have some misses, such as The Lady Killers, I Didn't Like a Serious Man. I felt, you know, there were good elements of it, but I thought that it lacked overall. So I guess I'd like to see the, you know, I don't know why the Coen brothers are resting on their laurels. I think that that's not good for anyone. So what do you think? Is this a film that you would see in theaters? Or would you rent it? Do you also have the same degree of respect for the Coen brothers that I do? And do you wish that Adam Driver and Justin Timberlake were in this trailer? What you saw, was that enough? Also, on a side note, it reminded me very, very small bit about The New Girl. The two lead actors, Zooey Deschanel, and I forget the guy who plays her semi-love interest, but he kind of looks like the lead here. So the film also reminds me just a tad of that as well, which I think is interesting. That's a pretty good show. All right, so write your thoughts down below. And as always, thank you for coming to be on the trailer, not just for the latest trailers, but these quick snapshot reviews. Thanks for watching. Bye.